Namaste children. Today we are going to learn the Champa flower by Rabindranath Tagore.
The Champa flower by Rabindranath Tagore. Supposing I became a Champa flower just for fun, I'll grow on a branch high up that tree and shook in the wind with laughter and danced upon the newly budded leaves. Would you know me, mother? You would call, baby, where are you? And I should laugh to myself and keep quite quiet. I should slyly open my petals and watch you at your work. When, after your bath, with wet hair spread on your shoulders, you walk through the shadow of the champa tree to the little court where you say your prayers, you would notice the scent of the flower, but not know that it came from me. When after the midday meal, you sat at the window reading Ramayana, and the tree shadow fell over your head and your lap, I should fling my wee little shadow onto the page of your book just where you were reading. But would you guess that it was the tiny shadow of your little child? When in the evening you went to the cowshed with the lighted lamp in your hand, I should suddenly drop onto the earth again and be your own baby once more and beg you to tell me a story. Where have you been, you naughty child? I won't tell you, mother. That's what you and I would say then.
Rabindranath Tagore was a Bengali poet, writer, composer, philosopher and painter. As we are all aware, Rabindranath Tagore was a great poet who wrote the national anthem, Jana Gana Mana. This poem shows the emotional bond between the mother and child. The Champa flower by Rabindranath Tagore is a beautiful scented analogy between the child as Champa flower and the mother itself. How similar they are in terms of spreading the fragrance, giving shadow. The sun wants to become a Champa to express his holy and beautiful feelings of love towards his mom. See, because the love the sun feels for the mother is lovely and holy. The sun wants to become a Champa to express those feelings. Now, let's see the Champa flower poem in detail. In this poem, the child wants to imagine himself as a Champa flower. The child wants to play a new role of a Champa flower. It's a make-believe where the child says, suppose I become a Champa flower just for fun. Supposing I became a Champa flower just for fun and grew on a branch high up that tree and shook in the wind with laughter. Laughter means the act of love. Shook means shaken up. The boy imagines that he is a flower sitting right on top, high up on the tree. He starts thinking about what will happen to him when the entire tree starts shaking with wind and danced upon the newly budded leaves. When a new leaf grows on a plant, we all feel pleasant. Similarly, the child says that you laugh and start dancing because he is very happy as he is a newly budded leaf. Would you know me, mother? You would call, baby, where are you? and I should laugh to myself and keep quite quiet. The child feels curious to know whether his mother would recognize him when he becomes a champa flower. He imagines that his mother would start searching him and keep calling him baby. But he decides to have fun and remain quiet. And I should slyly open my petals and watch you at your work. Slyly means in a knowing, secret manner. The child says that slyly, in a secret manner, the baby would open the petals of the champa flower and watch the work which was done by his mother. When after your bath with wet hair spread on your shoulders, you walk through the shadow of the champa tree to the little courts where you say your prayers, you would notice the scent of the flower but not know that it came from me. The child tells his mother that he looks at her when she returns after having her bath with wet hair spread on her shoulders. His mother walks through the shadow of the champa tree to the little court where she says her prayers. The child wants to know whether his mother would notice the scent of the flower but not know that it came from her little child. When after the midday meal you sat at the window reading Ramayana and the tree's shadow fell over your head and your lap, I should fling my wee little shadow onto the page of your book. Fling means throw. Wee little means very small. But would you guess that it was the tiny shadow of your little child? The child said that after the midday meal, when his mother would be reading Ramayana, the tree's shadow will fall on the mother's lap. The child imagined that he will also throw his small shadow on the book. The child is curious to know whether the mother will recognize if it is her own child's shadow. When in the evening you went to the cowshed, I should suddenly drop onto the earth again and beg you to tell me a story. Where have you been, you naughty child? I won't tell you, mother. That's what you and I would say then. In this stanza, the poet talks about the evening time when mother goes to the cowshed and she has a lighted lamp in her hand because it is dark at the time. Suddenly, the child says that though he wanted to be a champa flower by evening, he wants to drop down on the earth again and come back to his own form. He wants to be his mother's baby as he loves listening to the stories which his mother tells him every day. The child is sure that his mother is going to ask him that where has he been. The baby says that he won't tell his mother where he has been, and the conversation will go on between the mother and the child. That's all for now. Bye.